In this exercise, we're asked to estimate the effect of car's fuel efficiency on its price. We have data on 87 cars, and the dependent variable is the price of a car measured as true market value, and the independent variable is mileage, miles per gallon. That's the measure of fuel efficiency. So we estimate the regression where price is the dependent variable, and here we have just one independent variable, miles per gallon. What is the interpretation of the coefficient on mileage? Well, it's the difference between the expected price, given that the miles per gallon are miles per gallon I plus one, minus expected price, given that miles per gallon are equal to just some miles per gallon I. That is beta one. It's the effect of a one extra mile per gallon, one unit increase in fuel efficiency on the expected price of the car. And here we see that our estimate is a negative 829, meaning that for every 1 mile increase in fuel efficiency, the price of the car is expected to decline $829. And it's puzzling because we normally think of fuel efficiency as something good that should increase the price of the car. But here we find that the more fuel efficient the car, the less expensive it is. Could horsepower cause an omitted variable bias in the above regression? For an omitted variable bias to occur, two things have to happen. First, the omitted variable, horsepower, needs to be correlated with the included variable. So is horsepower correlated with miles per gallon? I think without knowing much about cars, or engineering, it's quite likely that miles per gallon are correlated with horsepower. Big engines, they use up a lot of gasoline and they have a lot of horsepower. Small engines, they don't have a lot of horsepower, but they also don't need as much gasoline to run. So this is probably, yes, horsepower is correlated with miles per gallon. The second thing that has to happen is that the omitted variable needs to affect the dependent variable. In our case, the omitted variable is horsepower. So we ask whether horsepower or does horsepower affect price. And without knowing much about cars, I would say yes. Horsepower is a good thing. The car is more powerful, faster, can carry more passengers and more cargo. Surely I would rather have more powerful car than less powerful car. And so I would say that horsepower affects price. So in this case, both conditions for an omitted variable to occur are satisfied. So let's see what happens when we try to cure the omitted variable bias by including the omitted variable into the regression. And we do that in model number two, where we regress the price of the car on both the mileage, the same variable as in the first regression, but we also include the omitted variable, or previously omitted variable, horsepower. So the regression equation looks something like that. We regress price on beta zero plus beta one miles per gallon plus beta two horsepower. What is the interpretation of the coefficient on mileage? What is the interpretation of beta one coefficient? Well, it is the effect of an extra mile per gallon on price, holding horsepower constant. If we write it out in terms of conditional expected values, it will look something like this. We have expected price given that miles per gallon are miles per gallon I plus one and some horsepower I minus expected price given just miles per gallon, MPGI, and horsepower I. The difference between these two conditional expected values is beta 1. It's the effect of adding an additional fuel efficiency, 1 mile per gallon in fuel efficiency, while holding horsepower constant, because the horsepower is the same here as it is here. The fuel efficiency is just 1 mile per gallon higher here than it is over here. And the difference between these two conditional expected values is how much higher or lower the price of a car is going to be if we manage to increase fuel efficiency by 1 mile while holding horsepower constant. What is the estimate of beta 1? The estimate of beta 1 is a positive 594. So now we see that fuel efficiency is actually a good thing. It increases the price of a car. Fuel efficient cars are more valuable than less fuel efficient cars, holding horsepower constant. And that's what we usually have in mind. When we say, is fuel efficiency good? Sure, fuel efficiency is good if you can keep my horsepower constant, if you can keep my passenger capacity constant. In those cases, fuel efficiency is good. And so here we have an example where without horsepower, we see that the effect of mileage is negative and statistically significant. But when we include horsepower, the effect of mileage is positive and statistically significant. And that's because including horsepower changes vastly the interpretation of the coefficient on mileage. In the first regression, it's just asking, hey, are fuel efficient cars more expensive than less fuel efficient cars? And we see that they are. They are less expensive because they probably have lower horsepower, lower passenger capacity, lower acceleration. But what we are really interested in is what is the effect of fuel efficiency on the price of a car if we can keep the horsepower constant? And if we can manage that, if we can increase fuel efficiency while holding horsepower constant, people like that. People like that to the tune of $594 for every 1 mile increase in fuel efficiency. That is the effect of fuel efficiency on the price of a car, holding horsepower constant.